program today, we have very exciting guests. We have Prime Minister Narendra Modi, we have Rahul Gandhi, we have Sushma Swaraj, we have Mayawati, Akhilesh Yadav, woof, practically every politician in town. And why is that? Because Youthquake today is coming to you from a mock youth parliament. The topic of discussion today is that what about disruptions in parliament? Are they today the biggest sin that is being carried out at the cost of the taxpayer? And today at the ARST College, we have these young people representing their leaders and perhaps providing them with a solution as well. So we, you know, like in parliament, a bill is introduced and then there are arguments and counter-arguments on both sides. They hope that it will be civil. Today again, we are looking into a situation where it will be brought in by the BJP, and the first word is being given to Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and let's see if Young India has a solution for disruptions in Parliament. Go ahead.
Tulsidas ji ne Rajdhan pe kaha tha, Dehik Devik Bhautik Tapa, Ram Raj nahi kahui vyapa. Sab nar karhi paraspar priti, chal hi swadharm nirit shruti niti. Inhi shabdo ke saath, Adhyaksh Mahoday, सभा में उपस्थित मेरे सभी साथियों, मैं आज की चर्चा का प्रारंभ करना चाहता हूं और मैं हाथ जोड़कर शुरू में ही आप सभी से विनती करना चाहता हूं कि संसद में जिस तरह उसकी गरिमा का अपमान हमने किया है, करते आए हैं, वो आज हम यहां पर उसको दोहराएंगे नहीं। सबसे पहले मैं अपनी निजी राय रख देता हूं कि डिसरप्शन के मुद्दे पर मैं ये मानता हूं कि जब तक आपके पास कोई और रास्ता नहीं बचता है, जब तक आपने बाक चर्चा के हर उस अलग अलग चीज़ों को आपने एक बार अपना के देख नहीं लिया, तब तक आपको डिसरप्शन नहीं करना चाहिए। और उसके ऊपर भी सबसे प्रथम चीज़ आती है नीति, नियत। आपकी नीयत कैसी है? आप बोलते हैं भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने भी डिसरप्शन किया था। साहब, हमने जब डिसरप्शन किया था तो 130 करोड़ रुपए एक्सचेकर के पास आए थे कोलगेट में, ए राजा जेल गए थे 2G के अंदर। आप जब डिसरप्शन करते हैं तो वो आप करते हैं किन चीज़ों पे? नेशनल हेराल्ड के ऊपर। क्या वो पार्लियामेंट में उठाने वाला मुद्दा है? क्या उससे पार्लियामेंट का कोई लेना देना है? नहीं है। इसीलिए अध्यक्ष महोदय, मैं आप सभी से ये गुजारिश करता हूँ, आपके द्वारा सभी से ये गुजारिश करता हूँ कि आज इस संसद में हम जो भी चर्चाएं करते हैं वो उस सांसद, उस ऑपोजिशन के नेतृत्व में नहीं जिसके प्रथम अध्यक्ष का ही अटेंडेंस रिकॉर्ड 52% है, उसके अंडर नहीं करें, क्योंकि उनको नहीं फर्क पड़ता कि पार्लियामेंट में क्या हो रहा है। हम उनके अलग अलग पार्टी से अलग अलग लोग आए हैं। मैं चाहता हूं कि सब अपनी निजी राय रखें, पार्टी से हट के रखना चाहते हैं, चाहे वो बीजेपी से क्यों ना हो, पार्टी से हट के रखें और अपनी अपनी राय रखें।
Since I'm the speaker today for today's program, I'm going to take the liberty to go and see who gets the next word. I'm going to let Rahul Gandhi respond to what the Prime Minister has just said.
सफलता
मान सरोवर चले जाइए।
अरे हम तो यही रहेंगे, आप बस पकौड़े तलना सिखाएं हमें यहाँ पे युवा को, और कुछ तो करना आता नहीं है, बस यही कराइए
आप। Okay, what do you have to say?
क्या सोने बनाने वाली मशीन आई? इधर से आलू डालो, इधर से सोना निकले।
इसमें आलू को सड़ा दें, लोगों को यहाँ पे खेतों में।
रफेल डील के बारे में आपने बताया, क्या हुआ उस डील का? निष्पक्ष, बिल्कुल ही निषेध निकली वो डील।
पर एक सेकेंड, आप मुलायम सिंह जी, आप मुझे ये बताएं कि आज जो डिस्कशन होना था वो तो डिसरप्शंस पे होना था, आप उसके बारे में क्या कहना चाहते हैं?
डिसरप्शंस के बारे में मैं ये बोलना चाहता हूँ कि देखिए, देश बहुत ही बड़ा है हमारा, 551 लोग बैठते हैं, विचारें अनेक हो सकती है, विचारों में हमारे असमानताएं आ सकती है, पर इसका ये मतलब नहीं निकलता।
स्पीच बंद दीजिए मुलायम सिंह जी, ये बताइए कि आप करेंगे क्या इसके बारे में?
मैं सोचता हूं कि रूल 349, 352, 374, 374A, इन सभी रूल्स को फिर से एक नए सिरे से देखना चाहिए, उसे इम्प्लीमेंटेशन में एक मजबूती लानी चाहिए। और जैसे कि जो
तो कुछ यादव कुछ नया लेकर नहीं आए हैं, वो कह रहे हैं जो रूल्स हैं उनको इम्प्लीमेंट करिए। डू यू हैव अ डिफरेंट ओपिनियन?
आई हैव एन ओपिनियन वेयर आई फील that actually when the Prime Minister is focusing on the fact that I have an attendance of 52%, can we just point out the fact that the Prime Minister doesn't even attend to answer the questions of the Parliament itself? We need questions, we have questions, would you answer the doubts actually? And when you expect the Prime Minister, who is the leader of the country, you don't answer on Rafael, which is strategically important for the defense of the country. When we put a question to that, you say that it is important to the security and it is confidential to the terms. Well, we also had that deal. We didn't have any such situation.
Mr. Gandhi, are you pointing out at their problems or do you have some solutions as well?
The problem is basically they are not willing to answer our doubts. If they're not willing to answer our doubts, the government is not functioning as per the norms of the ideology as to what the government was created. So we need check.
So you will disrupt?
Yes, no, we won't disrupt. We just need a check and balance system on the government itself. That's all we want.
Okay. All right, I see lots of hands going up. But since Rafael was being discussed, I'll let Nirmala Sitharaman answer that one.
Right. Mr. Gandhi, you're talking about disruptions. You are the one causing most of this disruptions here. This is extremely hypocritical of you to say that the Prime Minister is causing disruption. You are the one creating a ruckus in the Parliament for no possible reason. I have personally answered all questions possible related to Rafael. In fact, your party was the one who introduced Rafael and you did most of the dealing. How can you contradict yourself and just say that it is not true and it is wrong?
Again, Madam Nirmala Sitharaman, you're not talking about the disruptions. You're again putting the blame on him. And the last time I remember, he was the one distributing hugs in Parliament. He wasn't the one causing destruction, really.
No, so isn't that again? Yes, that is correct. He was the one distributing unwanted hugs. And surely he was not needed, and that violated the code of conduct for sure. Because winking is surely not something very sensible that a parliamentarian should do.
Okay, I want the discussion to focus on the agenda of the day, and the agenda of the day is disruptions. I have Mayawati raising his hand on this issue. Beg your pardon, that one. We're just doing a little fun debate over here. But tell me, what is the solution that your party has to offer when it comes to disruptions in Parliament?
The solution of our party is that the opposition should get a full opportunity to keep their point. Because when the opposition doesn't keep their point, then the debate will go ahead. Because the opposition is the one who is this society, छोटी सी छोटी दिक्कत इस संसद में लेके आता है. अगर मोदी जी ऑपोजिशन को सुनने के लिए ही तैयार नहीं होंगे तो फिर क्या होगा इस देश का?
तो आप कहना चाह रहे हैं डिस्ट्रप्शंस इसलिए बढ़ रहे हैं क्योंकि सरकार आपकी बात नहीं सुन रही है?
सरकार बात सुनना चाहती ही नहीं है, उनको सिर्फ अपना राज चाहिए.
ओके ओके, अखिलेश यादव एज अ पॉइंट.
देखिए, मैं सबसे पहले मोदी जी आपसे ये जानना चाहूंगा कि डिस्ट्रप्शन का मुद्दा आता कहां से है? डिस्ट्रप्शन पैदा हो क्यों रहा पार्लियामेंट में? क्या तुलसीदास ने ये नहीं कहा कि सच के रास्ते पे चलो? बोला था मैं चौराहे पे आऊंगा डिमोनेटाइजेशन के बाद. 2 साल हो गए क्या चौराहे पे आए? अब अगर जनता जवाब मांगती है और अपोजिशन आपसे बात कर ले और पूछ ले तो आपको लगता है डिसरप्शन हो रहा है पार्लियामेंट में? जवाब नहीं देंगे तो यही होगा.
ओके, उद्धव ठाकरे इज रेजिंग हैंड, देन आई लेट प्राइम मिनिस्टर रिस्पॉन्ड टू दैट.
भाजपा अपने गठबंधन के साथियों की सुनती ही नहीं है. महाराष्ट्र में हमारे किसी मंत्री की नहीं सुनी जाती. हम अपनी आवाज़ कहाँ उठाएं? संसद ही हमारा माध्यम है और हमारी आवाज़ को डिसरप्शन नाम देके हमें बदनाम किया जाता है. इसीलिए हमें
आप कह रहे हैं आपकी आवाज़ है डिसरप्शन वाली आवाज़ नहीं है, लेकिन इतना जो टैक्स पेयर्स का पैसा जाता है उसके लिए आपका सोल्यूशन क्या है? क्योंकि संसद ये जो पंखे बिजलियाँ यहाँ पर चल रही हैं, ये जो टैक्स लोग पे करते हैं उससे चलती है.
सॉल्यूशन ये है कि जो रूलिंग पार्टी है वो अपने गठबंधन के साथियों की भी सुने और हम मिल बैठ के एक सॉल्यूशन निकालें उस चीज़ का.
सो मोदी जी, आप पर जो इल्ज़ाम लग रहा है वो ये लग रहा है कि आप दूसरों की बात नहीं सुनते हैं, इसलिए अपनी बात सुनाने के लिए उन्हें डिस्ट्रप्शन करना पड़ता है.
मैडम, मैं आपको बता दूं कि ये सारे इल्ज़ाम बिल्कुल बिल्कुल गलत है. मैं तीनों आरोपों का जवाब दूंगा. सबसे पहले अखिलेश यादव जी को बोलूंगा कि जनता ने जवाब दे दिया है साहब, आपको दे दिया है उत्तर प्रदेश के चुनावों के बाद, नोटबंदी के बाद. उसके बाद मायावती जी, आप देखिए यही डिसरप्शन. देश का प्रधानमंत्री बोलता है और एक सांसद उनको टोकता है बीच में, इस तरीके की अभद्रता.
All I have to say is बैठ जाइए.
उसके बाद मायावती जी कहती हैं कि संसद में उनकी बात नहीं सुनी जाती, तो आपने रिजाइन क्यों किया? मैडम, आप बैठ के अपनी बात सुनाते. आपका टर्म पूरा हो रहा था तो आपने SC ST का मुद्दा उठा के 2 दिन पहले रिजाइन कर दिया ताकि आपका मुद्दा बन जाए. हम आपकी बात सुनते थे. आपको ये बहाना बनाना होता है ताकि आप एक मुद्दा बना सके सर, क्योंकि आपके पास कुछ और बोलने को नहीं है. जहां तक
जी, आप पर आरोप ये लग रहा है कि जब आप ऑपोजिशन में होते हैं, और आप तो पहली बार इस पार्लियामेंट में आए हैं, लेकिन जब बीजेपी भी ऑपोजिशन में होती है तो वो यही काम करती है, उस पर क्या आपका कहना है? या फिर आई वुड वांट लाइक एन ओल्डर पॉलिटिशियन आल्सो टू रिस्पॉन्ड टू दैट. अडवाणी जी बताएंगे इस पर कि आप तो इतने सालों से पार्लियामेंट में हैं, आपके हिसाब से क्या सोल्यूशन है स्मूथ वर्किंग ऑफ पार्लियामेंट के लिए?
द फैक्ट ऑफ द मैटर हियर लाइज इज as we have seen that Rahul Gandhi is the champion of women empowerment. But when we as a government presented the bill to support menstrual leave for women, the MP of Congress opposed that bill. And out of 2 hours of discussion, only 30 minutes of discussion was available for its presenting. And 1.5 hours was wasted on disruption. And when we presented the triple talaq bill, and then they also opposed. And because of that, we have to produce an ordinance in recent times. So how can they call that they are the champions of women empowerment? Lastly, I would like to...
But that's not the question of and the point of discussion today. The point of discussion today is how do we end disruptions in Parliament?
The basic thing, the way we can end, because the past 4 years of our government, there has been maximum disruption, and it is only because of one person, which is Rahul Gandhi. Remove him from the Parliament and you will see a good governance, better governance.
Okay, I want to take a break at this point and let go of all the theatrics that people are talking about and how they perceive their leaders to be. We're going to slip into a very short break. On the other side, we're going to talk about the real issues and as they matter. If young India today were to take into the shoes of these politicians, would it be any different? How do they perceive and what do they feel when they actually look at Parliament and see nothing but disruptions on almost most of the sessions? That's coming up on the other side. So before the break, we gave you a glimpse of what the Parliament looks like at this point and how is young India actually perceiving it. But now to drop the theatrics of it, to actually come down to the serious question on where do the solutions lie. Let's get a word from young India. Do you have an opinion? And what is it that you guys feel that should be done to ensure that Parliament runs smoothly? I'm just going to come on the other side and get a word from there. Yeah. Yeah, go ahead.
There should be a limit on the permissible interventions, and there should be a report on the productivity of the parliament so that and there should be reporting of the parliamentarians who cause disruptions so that in the end they are ashamed and then they do not cause such disruptions, because country is the one who loses the most. So we have to
So you're saying name and shame those people, put it out in black and white into what exactly are, who are the people who are causing disruption. That's your point. You had a point to make, yeah.
By reducing the amount of limelight the media put on political parties, as they tend to get popular from it. And we can do it also by increasing the inner party democracy.
So
they can discuss the points between their ruling parties, and they'll avoid the disruptions and the conduction can take place.
All right, you had a point. Yeah, you had a point. Yeah.
There should be a better mechanism to choose our speaker, so he can be less politically motivated, and he can... apply those rules.
I like what you're saying. You're saying the solution lies in getting a more apolitical and a more authoritative speaker who will keep the house in order. That's what you're suggesting. Okay, that's an interesting point. You had something to say.
The basic scenario through which we can find out a solution is that 186 members of total 543 members have criminal charges against them. Yeah. So we should eliminate these leaders from the parliament so as to bring perfect and more authoritative and more clean parliament.
You're saying get more civil people, ensure that people who get into parliament do not have any criminal record, are educated, have better standards, and that's the key to getting a more civil debate. You had a point.
सबसे पहले तो जैसा भाई ने कहा कि पढ़े लिखे व्यक्ति को लाना चाहिए, ज़्यादा एजुकेशन नहीं होना चाहिए, at least 12th पास होना चाहिए, और अगर हम अपने टॉपिक पे बात करें तो एक बुद्धिमत्ता वर्ड है जिसे हम इंग्लिश में ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग कहते हैं. अगर उस तरीके से हम लोकसभा में कार्यरत हों तो शायद हम अपने जो पहलू आने वाला है उस पहलू को एक अच्छे तरीके से सामने ला पाएंगे.
I get that a lot of people here are moved by the fact, but I want to understand, as you people who are young, who are watching Parliament, watching in the live debates and the broadcasts that happen there, the winking and the hugs and the disruptions, the, you know, the throwing away of paper, etc., does that matter to you? Does your heart really pain when you see that money go to waste? And so if you were in charge, what would you do?
I think a clear solution would be, like, all the MPs believe that publicity, even if bad publicity, is good if they make it to the evening news. So I think a live telecast of disruptions should strictly be stopped so that they do not get that much of attention, that too disrupting the parliament and just taking attention from their...
you are saying cut down live streaming altogether because they are doing it of disruptions only.
Yeah. unnecessarily if they're disrupting the parliament just to seeking the attention.
But don't you think the argument is that don't you think that people need to see who is the one causing disruption and that's what fixes responsibility?
Ma'am, I would like to say that why everybody is overemphasizing disruption. Even you can change your position and look at it as a way which safeguards democracy, which is a way to get to the things more clearer. So actually, disruption is not the thing which is preventing democracy. It's one of those pillars on which democracy firmly stands. So yeah. I particularly feel being disrupted is one thing and take disruption in a manageable, in a positive manner or in a manageable way where you can get to things when things go hard down, when bills are not being passed, when millions of farmers are out there starving in the real life situation.
So you are saying you're actually for disruption. You're saying it's healthy for democracy. Exactly. That's your point.
Yeah. Right. The parliament is like a window to the world for our country, and there needs to be a fixed pattern of behaviors. And it's not right when people just walk off, wing, throw papers, and just be just stupid around it, right? So there needs to be a fixed code of conduct, and there needs to be some amount of punishment that is associated with it, right?
If punishment for those who disrupt. Yes. Okay, that's a strong one. Yeah.
देखिए disruptions एक चीज है, मगर अपने मर्यादाओं को उल्लंघन करना हमारे नेताओं में ये एक आदत सी बना ली है.
Solution क्या है इस आदत का?
Solution यही है कि हमें जैसे कि live telecast है, वो पूरा न्यूज़ आज देख रहे हैं कि न्यूज़ अगर कोई नेता अपने संसदीय क्षेत्र में, वो उसे पता है कि उसके संसदीय क्षेत्र में ये दिखाया जा रहा है, तो वो हाईलाइट ये अगर कैमरा फोकस लेने के लिए वो उस तरफ बढ़ता है, वो वैसे कार्य करता है.
अकाउंटेबिलिटी तो बढ़ती है उससे, अकाउंटेबिलिटी भी तो बढ़ रही है उससे.
सबसे सही इसका इलाज ये है कि रिडक्शन इन द सैलरी, उन्हें पीनलाइज करा जाए जो आइडेंटिफाई होते हैं स्पीकर्स. Yeah. जो जिन्हें स्पीकर्स आइडेंटिफाई करता है उन्हें उनकी सैलरी में रिडक्शन आना चाहिए, उन्हें बहुत ज़्यादा स्ट्रॉन्गली पीनलाइज करना चाहिए और एब्सटेन कर देना चाहिए इस पूरी प्रोसेस.
पीनलाइज करना चाहिए लोगों को. यू हैड अ पॉइंट. या
All the disruptors and the people having dissenting views should be given a separate time by the speaker. Maybe at the end of the session, some provisions for that should be made. Maybe at the end of the session, or maybe and those issues raised by the disruptor can be put by the speaker in front of the government in the next session.
In the next session, yeah.
Well, I feel a solution to this problem could be that a few days should be fixed for the opposition, wherein the opposition can set the agenda that is to be discussed in the parliament. By glowing from the global experiences, in the UK parliament, 20 days are reserved from the opposition, and in the Canadian parliament, 22 days are reserved for the opposition. Mm. So I feel that some days should be reserved for the opposition, wherein the opposition can set the agenda, and then the government can't shy away from discussing on those things.
All right, interesting point of view. You had a point to make, yeah.
The solution could be that for any question or anything, only two leaders from a single party can give their views. Not only every member will give their views, because by doing so, we are just wasting time. Nothing else we are getting from it.
All right, so lots of views coming in here at Youth Parliament sits in for discussion. Interesting points of view. Some people saying, and mostly I think the maximum amount of feedback I've got here is the fact that people want those who are disrupting Parliament to be penalized, to be made to pay more, and also in a way maybe named and shamed in a manner that they do not do this. That's it on Youthquake this week. If you like a program, you can write to us at myyouthquake@ndtv.com. That's all the feedback will be coming. And if you're young, you're restless, you have an opinion, remember this is the platform for you, and we'll be there to ensure that gets on airtime. For this week, thank you so much for watching.